The practicality of providing it to consumers is another issue that is just not being addressed because it can't be addressed. More than 50% of the average carcass finishes in grinding beef, and you could have the beef from up to 300 cows in one hamburger patty. So the idea of identifying where each grain of beef came from in a patty is clearly ludicrous. And when you go into a boning room, you quickly realize that the practicality, apart from the fact that the consumers don't want it, just doesn't make sense. We were told that we could get abattoir feedback. Well, that's just not happening in this country. Less than 50% of the abattoirs are actually taking off from the database the tags that go through. We were told to control disease outbreaks. Well, we know we could control them well enough with this. We've had hardly any disease in the country. We eliminated brucellosis and TB, and we haven't had foot and mouth disease, and we haven't had BSE. So what are we trying to prove? We're told that other exporting countries were doing it. We did some work, we couldn't find any. We were told it would reduce stock theft. Well, clearly that's ridiculous. Anybody who wishes to can cut the tag out, as one of the instigators said, but that's illegal. Well, of course, stealing stock's illegal. And that one has been abandoned. And then we got serious. They said it only costs $5 odd for the tag. Well, we did some work and we came upon the UK. United Kingdom has got a system of trace back, a paper trail. And in 2003, their parliament, their Auditor General's report on livestock tracking was released. And we got a copy of it. And it is frightening. They have 700 bureaucrats chasing 10 million cattle around the UK, with 20% of them missing, and it's costing $69 per head sold. And they've got 20% missing. Now, the increase in brucellosis was noted under this scheme. In other words, it's a complete failure, but there's so much face involved that they're not backing off. Now, put that onto the Australian scene, we've just got a disaster. We had a survey done by an independent group, and they soon discovered that less than 15% of producers had actually got an account with the database and gone into it. Those of us who have gone in have just found that it is quite farcical. We've got 50% and less of the animals we've sold have been recorded as being sold and killed. The sale yards are faithfully reading the tags with sophisticated equipment, which is all expensive, and the inter-property movements are not being tracked because the cost of doing it would be phenomenal. The UK's got about 50% of its farmers are computer literate. This country wouldn't have 20%. And consequently, very few people are using the equipment. Basically, it won't work. It's too complicated, and it's not doing what the old system was doing. It's making it even more complicated. We've also got a paper system where we fill a form in whenever we sell cattle, and that form is photocopied and goes off to all the buyers. Well, this is the National Vendor Declaration, which is the paper trail which accompanies everything. It's in triplicate, and I fill that in with, it's got my property identification number. Then I put the number of cattle, a description, I put the tattoo and the earmark, and then I declare that they haven't had treatment with fodders that have had any chemical treatment that may be banned. There's a very long list of the banned substances on the back. And I go through all that ticket, and then I sign it with taking responsibility for it. Now, they did a trace back trial on 300 head recently, and 75% they found with the NLAS, or they claimed they did, but they had to use the paper trail for the other 25%. In other words, the old system was perfectly capable of doing what's required, and that's animal health trace back. And the independent study into the scheme, which was done 6 months ago, came to exactly the same conclusion, that the old system did everything that people are looking for. Basically, we've got a repetition of the Y2K bug, where huge sums of money were spent on computers because at the stroke of midnight, at the end of the last century, all computers were going to collapse. Of course, it didn't happen. It was a furphy, but there was an enormous amount of money made. And in this case, the manufacturers of tags and the manufacturers of the mechanisms for reading those tags, their profits here in Australia have increased by 400 to 500% in the last 2 years since this became mandatory. And all I can say to you people in America is that you should fight this to the last person, because it makes no sense. It's going to add greatly to your costs. Forget about just the cost of the tag. It's the cost of the bureaucrats and the people on the database that will really mount up. The UK government has been paying for it. Here in Australia, the producer is paying for it. And we're only just beginning to realise the number of people that will be required to try and make this work. And even then, it won't work as well as the old system. So I recommend to you that you fight this all the way. Make sure you get those figures from the United Kingdom. Make sure you look at what's not happening in Canada. Make sure you look at the disaster we've got here in Australia, and fight it all the way, because it is not in the interest of beef producers. It's not in the interest of beef consumers. And anyone in the middle is only making money at the expense of both. So thanks very much for listening to me.